Hello, hello, hello again. Happy Friday. Super excited to welcome everybody back to Tell Me Something Good. This is the opportunity to share good stuff with everybody that's online, everybody that's looking for direction, no negative. And I could not think of a better person than my friend Heather to join us and tell us something good. Heather G, you're on the clock.
Steve, thank you so much for having me. You know, obviously we're in such a complicated time, but I think more than ever, this is the time where, you know, you have two options when things are bad. You have the option is lay down or stand up. And, you know, and standing up right now could mean getting up and working out in the morning. You know?
That's right.
Cause, although hopefully everyone does. But really, I mean, you know, I'm seeing examples of people standing up all over the place, and it's really amazing, even though things are so terrible. So my something good is I turn off the news and I focus on how I can make an impact on other people's lives every day. You know, obviously, as the director of public relations and corporate social responsibility at Ultimate, that's part of my job, but it's how I'm fueling myself. You know, all the nonprofits that are out there that need so much help right now, and all of the, you know, the problems that need solving that you can't, I mean, neither you nor I have the opportunity to create a vaccine for the coronavirus, but we can provide a lending hand or some financial little bit of sense for nonprofits and for people that just need help right now. So something good for me is all of this community that's being created by this terrible tragedy that we're all moving through together.
So you, as people that don't know you, that should know you, are probably one of the most philanthropic people I know. So it's part of your nature. It's part of your fiber. Why don't you tell people a little bit about your endeavor, what you do to give back, how involved, what you're involved in, and sort of how that's manifesting itself in this new environment.
Absolutely. So as in my private life, I have been a volunteer for my whole life. I mean, literally following my mother volunteering since I was 3 years old.
Awesome.
And I, you know, just, she's amazing. My mom's probably volunteering right now, delivering meals for elderly seniors. It's always a great role model. And so for years I volunteered with were important to her, charities that were important to me. And you know, 10 years ago, actually I'm sorry, now 11 years ago, tragedy struck my life, and I was the, you know, the recipient of help from a nonprofit where I never thought that that would be my life. So my father, Dr. Robert Geronimus, was killed by a drunk driver when he was crossing the street on foot.
Wow.
You know, like the most terrible day, the most terrible time of my life, like a time where you know, I really had to make that decision about standing up or laying down. And for a long time I did lay down. I'm not perfect. But
yeah.
Driving reached out to me and supported me. We provide victim services for free of charge for victims of this tragedy. And it just boosted me up in a way that I never could have imagined. It provided help that I didn't know that I needed, and helped me move through that process of seeing the person who killed my father in court, seeing him go to prison, seeing him come out of prison. You know, things that people don't really know how to deal with until it happens to them. So I was so struck by that support that I received that I knew that I had to do something for this organization. You know, and previous to that, MAD was something that I remembered from high school, you know, a very shocking presentation about drinking and driving, but I never thought it would cross paths with me again. And it
until it touches your life. I mean, for a lot of people.
Yeah. And you know, we've had conversations about this before, that really Mothers Against Drunk Driving is for everyone, because everyone's out there on the roads together. So my initiative a decade ago, which is really crazy, I was a lot younger when I started this thing, to get to people before tragedy occurred. And, you know, you and I see each other at every nonprofit event there is. So I wanted to start a nonprofit event for Mothers Against Drunk Driving. We were doing no fundraising county before that. So I started Walk Like Mad at Mad Dash Fort Lauderdale, which is a 5K Always happens last Sunday, April, although not this year. But we were supposed to celebrate the 10th annual Walk Like Mad in Mad-Fort Lauderdale in a couple weeks, and we've pushed it to the fall, so we're still doing it. But it's largest.
Oh, great.
Yeah. I'm not going to not have that 10th anniversary event. We worked too hard. Awesome. And that fundraiser is the largest and fastest growing 5K for Mad in the country. So the Broward community, the Tri-County area has really embraced the cause, and people are understanding that they have the power to stop drunk driving. It's not just my issue, because my father was killed by a drunk driver. And along the way, I've joined the National Board of Directors of MAD, and now I actually am the board chair of the National Board of Directors of MAD. Thank you. Which is, really amazing, and also a whole other complication with this coronavirus, because, just like every business, nonprofits are being hit. So it's a really interesting set of challenges that we're moving through, but still learning so much about each other and about how to take our things online, just like you have with this. We're doing victim services via Zoom. We're doing victim impact panels where offenders have to, offenders are sentenced to, and part of their sentencing is seeing a victim impact panel where a victim like me will tell my story. We're doing that online. Like, we've really found out a lot about how flexible and resilient we can be as an organization. And I think that's really going to be one of the most interesting things that comes out of this, is how like testing really your mettle, right? Like, how can you be flexible? How can you continue to serve the people that you serve, whether you're a for-profit business or a nonprofit business, and how can you still connect with people? I got to tell you, I've been talking to my best friend who I went to high school with at Pinecrest. We graduated a long time ago. She lives in London. I talk to her every day now, which is amazing. We didn't have time before. You don't have time to your best friend. We've been since we were 13 years old. So it's really, this is a really trying time, but there are some good things about slowing down a little bit.
I mean, I think you bring up a great point that it's a test. I mean, all of my clients, all of the people that I work with on a regular basis, my son put it great the other day. He said, this is a detour, not a stop sign. So, it's sort of, you got to learn to adapt and move. And, it's not how anybody planned it. I'm a goer. So to be confined is not exactly the easiest thing for me. But I think to your point, if you look at the bright side, and I think I had read this, and correct me if I'm wrong, but because there's so much less people on the road, and because there's nobody really going to restaurants and doing all like that, the amount of drunk driving incidents has plummeted.
Yes, absolutely. Traffic crashes in general have gone down, and drug driving crashes as a result have also gone down. We'll see. It'll be interesting to look back and see over the period of time and see what that impact really is. But it is a good time to for that, and hopefully hopefully people come out of this as it relates to drunk driving more aware. Obviously, what you're consuming when you're sitting at home. Like, if you take that kind of awareness back to when you have a car. It's just interesting, and when it comes to drunk driving, obviously when things are normal, there's zero excuse anymore. I mean, not everybody has good public transportation, like they do up in New York, but like, we certainly don't have great public transportation, but cabs and Ubers and Lyfts and whatever, there's so many options, or walking. I mean, that's another thing I've discovered during this time. I am walking every night. It turns out Los Olas is really close to where I am. Like, I can actually get there on foot. I don't know if I would do it in heels, but
you bring up great points that I think people are finding friends and family and, this communal idea of we don't need all the frills to really entertain ourselves and really get value. For me, I'm devouring information at a rate I couldn't do before, just was too consumed with busyness. Now it's more productiveness, so even in parts of Europe, they're talking about pollution is gone, and that you can see the water in Venice, and there is a silver lining. I'm grateful that nobody in my family is sick with the virus, and it would be terrible if that were the case. But the reality is you have no choice, or you do have a choice to make it the most you can. And you always seem to be smiling no matter what. I mean, you've done a great job with your charity. So what happens in your business life now? How is that? How has all of this affected, you know, you and Ultimate? Didn't you just go through a merger? And this, so there's all kinds of activity there.
We did. We announced our merger on February 20th, and that seems like a lifetime ago because we've been, you know, basically self-isolated since the beginning of March. But we did close our merger. You know, things are moving forward. Our, you know, the company is twice as big now. We have co-headquarters here and in Lowell, Massachusetts. And, you know, for Ultimate, we really had the privilege of being able to switch to being totally virtual very easily because 40% of our employees were already virtual and most of us had at least one virtual day. So I heard this on the news and I was like, I I'm not perfect. I've been in a funk in the last couple of weeks more than once. But the other day I was listening to the news and I do that very rarely, like a little bit in the morning and a little bit at night, just so I can know what's going on, but not get consumed by it.
I agree.
They said that self-isolation is a privilege. So if you think about it, and particularly for you and me, like we feed off of people and we're missing that people, like all seeing people and hugging people and getting that energy. But it's a privilege for us to be able to do this and still maintain our jobs and our livelihoods. And we don't have to expose ourselves to people. We don't work in a hospital or a supermarket or somewhere where we're coming into contact with so many people. And it's confining, but it's amazing that we can do this. So, you know, we're really lucky at Ultimate. Everyone's doing great. We've had to pivot, you know, to online events and online everything, just like everyone else. But we were really well positioned to do it because so much, you know, we're a technology company. So we're lucky in that way.
That's awesome.
The stories that we're hearing from our customers, the CEO of Texas Roadhouse, you know, he gave his salary up so he could keep people employed. I mean, there's really amazing things going on out there from our customers and from our, you know, from our own community. We are, we're doing a disaster match for the Center for Disaster Philanthropy, which is an organization that funds the highest and greatest need for in times of disaster.
Wow. How about that?
That's really amazing. So 12,000 people now, because we were 6,000 before, and now we're 12,000 people have the opportunity to donate to this cause, and then Ultimate and Kronos are going to match at 100%. So that's really, you know, that's the kind of things that get me up in the morning, you know, figuring out how we can help, where we can help. Yeah, and then I think all of our sports partners are amazing. Feeding South Florida has had obviously a huge need because the food hunger becomes one of the number one issues when all this stuff happens. So Ultimate was able to get involved and the Miami Heat got involved in a big way. The Florida Panthers, the Marlins, everybody has stepped up. And it's really, really cool to be able to connect those dots and say, you know, here's over here, we have this need and let's get all our partners together and let's, you know, lift the community up.
I mean, that's why I love hanging around you and hearing what you say, because it's all about giving and doing and connecting. I had read something that Udonis posted about his Miami, and I got like chills. I mean, it's, you know, because people don't realize how much people depended on the system to feed them, schools and that kind of thing. And it was shocking to me. And I said to my son, who's now the president of the company, I said, we got to do something. We got to get involved. We got to get everybody we know to donate $1. And then all of a sudden, all of that power happens. So I'm thrilled to hear that you guys pivoted on that. And so on a Friday afternoon, you've given us lots of great positivity. You've given us a great smile. Do you want to leave us with one last thought?
So I'll end the way I started, really. You know, this is the time where we all have to decide to take a stand. And even if it's just taking a stand for yourself and doing, you know, giving yourself a little bit more self-care or calling your grandmother or donating a dollar to a nonprofit, just, you know, really when things get tough, just remember, you know, how good we do have it. If you have your health and you have your family, that's a great base. So, you know, don't take this laying down, you know, really stand up, turn this crisis into purpose in some way, whether it's for yourself or for your company or for your family or your community.
I knew you'd be a great guest. I'm so thrilled that you took the time to join. You know, if you need me for anything or any of the causes, feel free to reach out. But that was definitely something good, Heather G. You'd be good. I'll see you soon, hopefully. Okay.
All right. See you soon. Bye.